kids. Welcome, hello, we're glad you're here.
Well, welcome to Lake Grove Kids, everybody. I'm Mr. Mark.
And I'm Miss Leslie.
And we're with Lake Grove Kids at
Lake Grove Presbyterian Church.
As you know.
We're so glad you're with us today. Let me show you what you're going to need today. You're going to need some aluminum foil to maybe do some sculpting with aluminum foil as you listen today. I also wanted to give you an update on our ordinary time bulbs that we planted. They are still growing, still having new life.
Now we have something to show you. It's rather interesting. I'm going to hold one, and Leslie is going to hold one. Can you see what these might be?
Can Any you tell? Ideas?
Do they look maybe like faces? And
oh.
Do you notice anything familiar about the faces? Why are we showing you aluminum foil faces today? Well, you will find out shortly when you hear our true Bible story from Miss Leslie about how we're created in the image of God and designed to reflect Him. Mm-hmm. Reflect means to show Him to the world around us. Let's worship together.
Lift your name on high. Lord, I love to sing your praises. I'm so glad you're in my life. I'm so glad you came to save us. You came from heaven to earth to show the way, from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay.
Now in the call to worship, and we're going to do it call and answer style.
Okay.
And so you do what I do and say what I say. We're going to say this. We live for Jesus.
We live for Jesus.
We live by Jesus.
We live by Jesus.
We live with Jesus.
We live with Jesus.
We live through Jesus.
We live through Jesus.
And we live in Jesus.
And we live in Jesus.
Let's pray together. Will you pray with me? God of grace, let Jesus be praised in all that we say and do, in all that we think and speak, now in this time of worship, and in every moment of our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. And now, we're going to sing together. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Worship His holy name.
Bless the Lord, O my soul. Soul, worship His holy name. the sun comes up, it's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, O my soul. His holy name, sing like never before. Oh, my soul, I'll worship your holy name. I'll worship your holy
Wow. That's tricky.
That's tricky. You're going to have to wait till the very end to figure it out.
There's a few of those I think I remember, but some I didn't. Mm-hmm. How about you?
Stay with us. We'll remind you what it is. Let me pick up my Bible. It dropped on the ground. Just a minute, everybody. There we go. If I asked you to describe Mr. Mark over here, what words would you use? Or if I asked you to describe your mom, what words would you use? Or your best friend? Or even yourself? What words would you use? Would you use words that were the same or different, depending on who you were describing? Well,
it's shiny.
It's shiny.
I can see my face reflected in it.
Yep, I can see mine. You know, as Mark and I look at it, I'm seeing that, you know, Mr. Mark over here doesn't have a lot of hair. And I have really gray hair. And Mark has brown eyes. And I have green eyes. And he's 6'3". And I'm 6'2".
We're different, you're saying?
We're different.
Okay.
We're different, but we're both made in the image of God.
Hmm.
Just like your mom or your dad or your grandma or your grandpa or your best friend or the people all the way around the world or even you. All of us are made in the image of God.
Even though we all look different.
Even though we all look different.
Okay.
Both in our physical bodies, what is seen, and also what is unseen in each of us. God created everything. Everything that is seen and everything that's unseen. He made us, Mark and I, and you, in His image. We are made to reflect Him, His goodness, His wisdom, His love. You know, in the book of Genesis, in that very first book in the Old Testament, in the very first chapter, God creates heaven and earth. Light comes and He calls it day. And darkness comes and He calls it night. He creates space between the waters, naming it the sky. And He calls the dry land into existence. Plants fill the earth. Birds fill the air, sea creatures fill the oceans, and animals roam on the ground, filling the world. God calls all that He created good. But then God says, let us, God, Jesus, and the Holy Spirit, that Trinity that we talked about last week, He says, let's make human beings in our image, like us. Let us make humans in our image so they reflect our very nature. So right there, those words from God give us a clue to what God means when we're created in His image. We're made in His image just like Jesus, using all of God's creativity and imagination. Each of us is made up of what is seen and what's unseen. And you know, there's more to us than what our bodies show. Our hair color, our skin color, our eye color.
More to us than what we look like.
More to us what we look like. We're made in the image of God in what is also unseen. Mm. We are created to reflect His wisdom, His goodness, and His love. But God didn't just speak us into existence. He breathed His own breath into us. And filled us with His life. We are different than any other thing He created. We are created to be in relationship with Him and to reflect who He is. Nothing else in creation is made in God's image. Only us. Each of us, you and me, are His masterpiece. His creation, His handiwork, His poem. Each of us are created by Him for a very special purpose. We are made to be the children of God. It doesn't matter what our talents are, what our age is, what our intelligence is, what our bodies can or can't do, what our skin color is. We are all made in the image of God. God made us different and diverse and delights that we are His children. His crown of creation, that's us. God wants us, you and me, to reflect Him to the world. His goodness, His wisdom, His love. We are created by Him to belong to Christ Jesus, so we can do work, good works that reflect His image to the world. Mm.
That's encouraging and comforting and amazing.
We are amazing. We are children of God. You know, one of the things we're doing this month in LGK is spending time in prayer, quiet prayer, silent prayer, just resting in the very presence of God. And I have to tell you, I'm not really very good at that. It's really hard for me. So I wanted to show you something that helps me get in the practice of being quiet with God and just listening for the sound of His voice. I have this pink sticky note stuck on the wall behind my computer, and it says...
Yeah, I read it.
Uh-huh.
It says, 2 o'clock, rest time, sit quietly.
And that's a reminder for me every day to take some time at 2 o'clock to sit quietly and listen for the voice of God. Let's you and I and Mark do that together right now. Let's sit quietly, listening for the voice of God. Amen. Before we go, we wanted to know if you figured out was the message and the Bible verse that we said earlier that didn't have any spoken words. Let's say it together. We are God's creation. We belong to Christ Jesus. Now we can do good works. Ephesians 2:10. We are made in God's image. We belong to Him. And we are to show His goodness, His wisdom, and His love to the world. Thanks for being with us today.
Well, that makes this seem like a perfect song right about now. It's me.
See you next time, everybody.
It's very hot in there, by the way.
It is hot in there.
So long, farewell, goodbye, Lake Crumpets. So long, farewell, goodbye, Lake Crumpets. So long, farewell, goodbye, Lake Crumpets. So long, farewell, see you soon.
Bye, everyone.
Bye, everybody.